What's going on, y'all? This is DK Smith. Today, I'm gonna talk to you all about this thing right here. The US dollar. Oh, it's $20. I have a dollar in my pocket, so I'll have 20s. Anywho, let's talk about what's going on today in the world, right? And all this trade talk and this currency manipulation and China's doing this and blah, blah, blah. All that stuff, but let's really boil down at what does it actually mean to the everyday individual like yourself. So I'm gonna tell you, you know, some of the pros and the cons of having a strong dollar. Right now, you know, we're in a trade war with China. Global currencies like the, you know, euro, the pound, they're all dropping. The RMB is dropping, renminbi is dropping, and the dollar is strengthening, right? The dollar is the reserve currency of the world. It's gaining power. But what does that mean for you? Why do you care? You know, you're sitting here, what the hell does that mean for you, right? Well, several things, right? And four main things. Number one, it means that traveling abroad will now be a lot cheaper and more affordable. So instead of the dollar being, you know, 1 to 1.3 against the euro, you know, you may see it be, you know, 1 to 1.15 or 1.1 or something. You know, it'd be a lot cheaper for you to go take that trip to Croatia you always wanted to take. So, you know, when the dollar is weak, when the dollar is strong, that's when you want to go because, you know, things get cheaper for you. But conversely, it means that traveling to America, if you're abroad or if you're a tourist, gets a lot more expensive. All things being equal, you should start seeing a decrease in tourism, you know, from abroad into America because it'd be a lot more expensive for them. So if, you know, if you're living in Spain and you're gonna go take that family trip to Chicago, you know, you may second guess that. Maybe instead of going to Chicago, you may go to Amsterdam instead, right? Because it's cheaper, it's closer, you know, you don't have to worry about the American dollar. And your money's not gonna be worth less. So why do you care? If you're an American, you're here, like I don't care if you, you know, the Spanish people are traveling abroad, who cares? You should care because that means that we have less foreign money coming in. So there's less money from outside, you know, everyday travel and tourism coming into America. So you're gonna start seeing, you know, the tourism and hospitality industries suffer a little bit. I'm not sure how much, I don't know. But, you know, you should start seeing some downturn, a slight downturn. I was reading a report yesterday for a client, not for fun. It was fun, anyway. but the hospitality industry has been growing, you know, the last 10 years, 4.4%. You know, it's just been incredible, and it's projected to still grow. It was projected to grow 7%, but you know, that was before all this trade war stuff and this currency manipulation and, you know, the strong dollar came into play. So now I think that growth is probably gonna flatten a little bit, maybe even decrease. So if you're in the hospitality industry, you know, you depend on foreigners coming in and, you know, as tourists, you think that's how you're gonna make your money, you know, you may want to start saving up, because you may see a dip in your profitability or at least your top line revenue in the next year or two once this trade war and this, you know, the strong dollar really takes effect around the world. The next point is that for Americans or for anyone that uses the dollar, it will now be cheaper for you to buy goods that are made outside of America. Again, it's great, right? You can get those pair of Moroccan slippers you've always wanted or too expensive, right? Yeah, so, you know, you can do that. You can go travel abroad, go shopping. You know, now is the time if you were ever gonna go shopping and travel abroad, well, not now, but probably 6 months from now, when the dollar's even stronger, because, you know, your money will be valued a lot higher. And you can buy more things, right? It's cool, right? It's great. The flip side of that is if you are an American manufacturer or producer, or you sell services and you're trying to sell services abroad or products abroad, and you are an exporter and you make your money exporting, you should probably save up some of that money, because you all things being equal, economic theory says that you will see a dip in your demand, because that good, you know, you made a widget and you're selling it to Ukraine, or London, say London, right? You're selling a widget to London. You haven't done anything. You're selling widgets like clockwork. They love it. You know, it's great. Now all of a sudden the dollar strengthens. They can't buy as many widgets, you know, in London. So you start seeing your demand decrease and your quantity start to go down, which would be a dip in profitability. Should be a dip in profitability for you you know, in the short term. So just start thinking about right now, today, before this trade war and this strong dollar starts taking effect, you know, the next 3 to 6 months, or maybe a year, but, you know, probably 3 to 6 months. Prepare for that. You know, if you're an export business right now, prepare. How can I be, what can I do to pivot, to tactically pivot, you know, in the short term while this dollar strengthens? Maybe that means, you know, instead of relying on so many exports, you're trying to find a domestic market to penetrate, right? Just start thinking about those kind of things. If you have any questions, feel free to DM me. You know, Mr_DK_Smith on Instagram. Follow me, at me, like this post, whatever. And DM me, challenge me, question me, call me out. You know, if I'm wrong, let me know. I love talking about it. If you have a different opinion, let me know what you think. If you want to learn more about economic theory and economic policy and, you know, what all this stuff in the news actually means for you as an investor or as a consumer in America, hit me up. I'm here to answer questions. I love this stuff. Subscribe to my YouTube and all the other stuff that I'm supposed to say. Talk to y'all later. I'm out.